Welcome my dear children to your mathematics class. In your subtraction chapter, in the last session, we have learned about subtraction without borrowing. Today, we will see about subtraction with borrowing. Okay, so let us start and try to understand the steps. Subtraction with borrowing, or you can say with regrouping, both the meanings are one and same. Let us take example. Subtract 156 from 853. Now I already told for you in subtraction chapter, the question may ask in a different way. Subtract the number, sometime they may give from or minus sign, sometime they give first number smaller, second number bigger. So you people have to identify the proper number and always choose the bigger number as a first number minus smaller number. Okay, so let us start now. So 156 from 853. So first place the places, 3 digit, that is 1s, 10s and 100. Now which is the bigger number here? 853. So 3 in 1s place, 5 in 10s and 8 in 100 place. Minus. Subtraction with sign? Minus. Now, smaller number is 156. So, 6 in 1's place, 5 in 10's and 1 in 100 place. And now, let us start our subtraction. From which place? 1's place. Now, tell me, can you subtract 6 from 3? No, it's not possible. 3 is smaller number. Now, here we require to borrow from the neighbor. So, which neighbor? 10th place. Am I right? Yes. So you have to borrow from the 10th place. So after borrowing the number, how much you get here in the 1's place? 13. How much you get? 13. So now you can subtract 6 from 13. So 13 minus 6, how much you will get? Do and see. Yes, you will get 7. So here answer comes in the 1's place. 7. Now let us move to the 10th place. Now just now from the 10th place, one number has given to the 1's place. So how much left in the 10th place now? From 5, if one number went to the 1's place, how much left? 4. Am I right? Yes. Now can you subtract 5 from 4? No. Again 4 is a smaller number. So again we require to borrow from the 100 place now. So after borrowing, how much you will get here? 14. How much you will get? 14. Now you can subtract. So 14 minus 5, how much? From 14, remove 5. How much you will left with you? 9. So here comes our answer in the 10th place, 9. Now let us move to 100 place. Again from the 100 place, one number has given to 10th place. So how much left in the 100 place now? 7. One number less. So it is left with 7. So now we have to do 7 minus 1. Means 1 remove from this 7. After removing, how much you will get? 6. So here comes our answer in the 100 place. 6. So we get the answer 697. So how to write in the hands? Hands 853 minus 156 is equal to 697. Keep in the mind some points here. Arrangement of numbers is very important. Choose always bigger number minus smaller number. Arrange properly down each number, 1s, 10s, 100 and all. Then copy the correct number from question to the answer. Don't change any number. After solution, write hands properly. How you arrange the number bigger minus smaller, like that only you arrange in the hands. Okay. And one more thing. When you are borrowing some number, don't forget to write how much left. Okay. That is very important. Let us take next example. Subtract 900 minus 612. So first arrange the places. So now here directly they are given bigger number first. So 900 arrange properly in the place. Then comes minus sign, then smaller number is 612. So 2 in the ones place, 1 in tens place and 6 in hundred place. Okay, let us start to solve from ones place. But tell me, in the ones place here it is 0. Can you subtract 2 from 0? No. But if you see in the tens place is also 0. Yes or no? So first, tens place has to borrow from the hundred place. Then only tens place can give number to the ones place. Na? Okay. So first, borrow the number from hundred place. After borrowing the number from the hundred place, how much tens place will get? 10. How much will get? 10. Now, so once you give the number to the tens place, how much left with the hundred place? 8. Don't forget to write that. Okay. Now let us move to the ones place. Now ones place can borrow from the tens place. So after borrowing, how much get in the ones place? 10. And how much left with the tens place now? 9. Okay. Now we can start our solution. So step number 1, 10 minus 2 means from 10 remove 2 numbers out. How much left with you? Yes, it is 8. So here comes our answer in the ones place is 8. Now let us move to the tens place. Now tens place upside, how much number is there? 9. So 9 minus 1, how much you will get? 9 minus 1, 8. Again you will get here 9 minus 1, 8. So here comes. Now let us move to the hundred place. Now hundred place upside, which number is there? 8. So 8 minus 6. Remove 6 from 8. How much answer you are getting? 8 minus 6 is 2. Am I right? Yes. 8 minus 6 is 2. So here comes answer 2 in the 100 place. Now what answer we get? 288. So hence 900 minus 612 is equal to 288. Okay. Difference. See here. Each question is different type. But you have to understand. Process is everything same. Only choose bigger number minus smaller number and minus sign. So difference, find the difference 673 and 285. So place the number, then bigger number which here 673 minus, difference means again minus, smaller number 285. So after arranging properly down of each numbers, then let us start from the ones place. So our step number 1. Can you subtract 5 from 3 now? No, because 3 is smaller number. Again we have to borrow from tens place. So after borrowing, how much we will get in the ones place? 13. How much you are getting? 13. Okay. So 13 minus 5, how much? 8. 13 minus 5, 8. So here comes our answer, 8. Now let us move to the tens place. Now from 7, already one number has given to the ones place. So how much left here? 6. How much left? 6. Okay. Now, can you subtract 8 from 6 now? No. 6 is smaller number. Again, we have required to borrow from 100 place. So after borrowing, how much we will get in the tens place now? 16. Step number 2, to borrow, and how much we will get? 16. Now you can subtract 16 minus 8. So remove 8 from 16. How much left? 8. So here comes our answer, 8 in the tens place also. Now let us move to the hundred place. Now just now one number given to the tens place. So how much left in the hundred place now? 5. And now we have to do step number 3, that is 5 minus 2. 5 minus 2, how much? 3. So here comes our answer, 3. So don't forget how much left and all. Okay. So here we get the answer 388. So hence 673 minus 285 is equal to 388. Difference. Find the difference. 640 and 829. See here, and is given, first number given smaller, second number bigger. So choose according to proper pattern. So here our first step is to choose bigger number. So which is the bigger number? 829. Place properly, then minus sign, and then smaller number is 640. Write that proper way. And now let us start our solution from ones place. Now step number 1. 9 minus 0. Can you do? Yes. 9 minus 0. What answer you will get? 9. Any number minus 0, you will get that number itself. Am I right? Yes. So 9 minus 0, 9. So here we get the answer downside in the ones place, 9. Now let us move to the tens place. Now here, upside B number is 2 and downside it is 4. So can you subtract 4 from 2? No. Again 2 is a smaller number. So we have to borrow now. So borrow from the which place? 100 place. So after borrowing, how much you get here? 12. How much you get? 12. Now step number 2. We can subtract 4 from 12. So 12 minus 4, how much you will get? 12 minus 4, 8. So here comes our answer in the tens place, 8. Now let us move 100 place. Now 100 place, the number is 8. But remember, already you have given one number to the tens place. So how much left here? Left with 7. Now from 7, you have to do minus 6. So 7 minus 6, 1. So here. So now let us write hands. 829 minus 640 is equal to 189. Okay. Subtract 800 minus 571. So first place the places. 800 is a bigger number. So 0 in the ones, again 0 in the tens, and 8 in the 100 place. Minus 571 is a smaller number. Okay. Now let us start. Step number 1. Now again, if you see here, we have to start from ones place. But here it is 0. Can you subtract 0 minus 1? No. Then ones has to borrow the number from tens place. But again, tens place also here it is 0. So first tens place has to borrow from 100 place. Then only he can give, na? Okay. So first in the tens place, the number will borrow from 100 place. How much we get? 10 here. Okay. Now ones place can borrow the number from tens place. After borrowing, how much you got? 10. And how much left in the tens place now? Because one number already has given to ones place. So here left with 9. Now we can start our step number 1. So 10 minus 1. 10 minus 1, how much? Remove 1 from 10. 9. So here comes our answer. 9 in the ones place. Now in the tens place, upside number left with 9. 9 minus 7. Do the step number 2. 9 minus 7. 9 minus 7 is 2. So here comes our answer. 2 in the tens place. Now let us move for the 100 place. Now already one number has given to the tens place here. So first, how much left here? 7. Now step number 3. 7 minus 5, how much? 2. So here comes our answer, 2. So we get the answer 229. Hence 800 minus 571 is equal to 229. Okay, children. Children, today we have learned about the subtraction with borrowing. Some points always keep in the mind. You have to arrange the number properly, choose the correct digit and copy in the answer. After that, when you are borrowing something, how much left in that proper place, you write it. Do your subtraction calculation properly and write the hands how you arrange according to that. Okay, in subtraction, however they give the number, always choose bigger number upside minus smaller number and do your calculation. Children, today we will wind up our session here. Next time with new subtopic. Till then, bye. Stay safe. Thank you.